All right, so yes, Nvidia has finally released its 20 series, and it's of course a very exciting review. We've been waiting 29 months since the release of the 10 series, and like any Nvidia release, it comes with a lot of hype, a lot of expectations, and this one in particular has a little bit more on its shoulders than the 10 series because there was such a mining explosion on the video card market that it's definitely a lot to unravel in this review. So today I am reviewing Nvidia's very own GeForce RTX 2080, the very first one to hit the market. And is it worth it? Is it as good as Nvidia wants us to believe? Well, go no further. You're in the right place at the right time. So without any further ado, roll that intro. Nvidia has been really, really good at surrounding its new series with a shroud of mystery. And until the very day of the keynote, we had no confirmed date about even its very name. We didn't know if it would be a 20 series or 11 series. We knew what would be in there. There was a lot of leaks regarding that, but yeah, those big question marks. And not only from the gaming community, we had the workstation community, and most importantly, or most noticeably, the crypto mining community. I mean, this is the very first video card Nvidia releases since the crypto boom of the end of 2017. So of course, everybody is expecting a lot from it. So in this review, we're not only going to look at the gaming or the workstation performances of the card, but we are also going to look at its crypto mining abilities. So without any further ado, let's do the usual old versus new comparative tables. And the very first thing we're gonna jump onto is of course the biggest change, the architecture. We are going from Pascal to Turing, jumping from a 16 nanometer lithography to a rather big jump, 12 nanometer lithography. That's going to allow us to put many more transistors in the die and having a better power efficiency. And logically, that does translate in more CUDA cores, about 20% more than the previous generation, the 1080 Founders Edition. But for once, it's not all about CUDA cores. There is something new in the RTX video cards, and that is two new kind of cores, the Tensor and the RT cores. First, we have the Tensor cores, 368 of them to be precise. And for the one who follow tech news, you will remember that those are the very same cores you can find in more expensive and focused Nvidia architectures, Volta architecture. And this is something Nvidia has developed not so much for gaming purposes, but more for artificial intelligence focused tasks such as autonomous driving and stuff like that. And they've been doing great in that domain. But what Nvidia is trying to do here is to use those Tensor cores to deliver something they call deep learning super sampling. And you know, that is a difficult concept for me at first to wrap my mind around, but what it does, it's to get away from the TAAs, the traditional anti-aliasing technology, which has been great for the past decade, but which is also very taxing on your hardware and has a lot of downfalls, such as blurry images, not very lifelike, and a little bit of tearing and stuff like that. So what DLSS will do is take a lifelike picture in your video game and try to take the lower quality and just reconcile them based on this. And that's where it starts to sound like a sci-fi book, because the cores will train themselves to recognize what lifelike should be and take away from the GPU or your processor the task of rendering images and do the job itself. It'll just guide them to give really those lifelike sequences. And you know, during the keynote, they did give some examples of what it would look like, and it was breathtaking. It really, really was. But again, that's at the keynote, because so far we do not have any game which takes advantage of this. And Nvidia just released the NGX API to developers, which will help them apparently easily and straightforwardly to develop deep learning super sampling compatible games. So an absolute groundbreaking advance if that is true, but something we still have to test and see. Second new cores that we have here are the RT cores. RT cores stand for ray tracing. And if you've watched the keynote, you'll understand that Nvidia has placed a lot of hope on ray tracing. They actually spent, I think, 75% or 80% of the 2-hour keynote to tell us what ray tracing was, where it came from, where it's going. And in a nutshell, ray tracing will simply try to recreate lifelike lighting conditions and effect, something that is already very present in the animation movie industry and stuff like that, but it's very expensive with very, very expensive video cards and computers. And for the first time, we have RT cores, which will have the focused task of reproducing those very cool effects. And if you looked at the examples we had during the keynotes, it's mind-blowing, but there are issues with it. For example, we still do not have RTX enabled video game. I don't. I mean, Nvidia has given us a couple of samples that you can download here and there, but nothing that you can play right now on a computer. I tried Tomb Raider, Shadow of Tomb Raider. I tried to see if it was enabled on Star Wars Battlefront 2, but of course, Windows has not yet released its 1908 October update, and that's important because this is where the ray tracing API will be nested in. So yeah, still waiting on that. And finally, we are passing from DDR5 to DDR6 memory, and that is a big step, and there was a lot of expectations out of this, especially in the crypto mining community. And we will talk more about this during benchmarking, but we can expect about 40% more compared to the DDR5 and 25% more compared to the DDR5X generation. For now, let's take a closer look to the actual gaming performances that the 2080 gave us. I have tested the 2080 RTX on the usual suspects, and starting with 3D Marks, the 2080 outperformed every card I had thrown at it, and it largely did so with its direct predecessor, the GTX 1080, but barely escaped the 1080 Ti, which is already 2 years old. Not a great sign. Gaming-wise, I have tested different engine, and starting with Doom, and through all the games I have tested, the RTX mainly came on top of the competition, but it was only 2-5% faster than the 1080 Ti. Again, a 2 years old video card. And this is a pattern that I have seen over and over and over again through the different video games. Moving to the crypto mining performances, I have tested only two cryptocurrencies, the big GPU ones, Ethereum and Zcash, and that's where things started to get ugly. On Ethereum and on the base clock, the RTX 2080 gave me about 35 megahash per second, and that compared to the GTX 1080 20 megahash, it's pretty good, it's almost double, but compared to the GTX 1080 Ti 37 megahash, again all on base clock, it pales. Let me add that lately we had a software, an add-on crypto mining software called Oh My God Enlargement Pill for Ethereum, something like this. I'll put it in the description, or I'm just gonna add a little box there to correct me. And what that software does is to make available the entire DDR5X bandwidth to crypto miners. And it only works for DDR5X, so only on 1080 and 1080 Ti. It won't work on 1070s and below. And what that does is higher hashing for Ethereum. And so for 1080, I'm finding myself at about 30 to 34 mega hash on a base clock, and on the 1080 Ti, 47 to 50 mega hash. That's 15 mega hash more than the new RTX 2080, and that means a lot in terms of efficiency. It gives us about 35 to 40% more mining power than the newest generation. And again, I'm gonna repeat myself, the 1080 Ti is 2 years old. And as Zcash mining goes, the RTX 2080 did shine a little bit more, giving me anywhere between 710 to 730 sol per second. I managed to overclock it all the way to 760 to 770 sol per second, which is pretty good, and giving us all the way up to 40% more than the GTX 1080, but right within the margin of error for the 1080 Ti, which does manage to give similar performances. That annoying 1080 Ti again. In conclusion, the RTX 2080 will retail at about $750 to $900 US, including tax, depending of the manufacturer, the make, etc., and the options. And well, I'll say this: Nvidia is trying to refocus the high-end gaming video cards to games. Right? They really focus on that. They brought in the two new cores, the deep learning super sampling, the Tensor Cores, as well as the RT Cores. And that's something that I can see as a natural evolution if you want to have more lifelike, better quality games. But they are real downfall. First, they really did put a lot of hope on those cores, because you do not know for sure if all the gamers and the big developers will follow them. I mean, Nvidia does pretend and does say that 25 major game studios are already developing ray tracing and DLSS compliant games, but I still have to see those. And to be frank, for the few I heard who did try ray tracing games, they came back with scary reports. They did say that playing Tomb Raider with ray tracing on will give them only 20 to 25 frames per second at 1K resolution, 1080. And, you know, that is really low. I mean, I'm not saying it's not unplayable, but, you know, going from having 40 or 60 frames per second in 4K to drop down to 20 frame or 24 or 25 frame per second in 1K, that is a lot of sacrifice Nvidia is asking to gamers, so that we're gonna have better lighting and better reflection and stuff like that. And I'm not saying it's not gonna be gorgeous, but that I'm not sure if everybody's gonna go for it or will be interested to go for it for such a downgrade in FPS. And I'm sure the 2080 Ti will fix this, or a 2080 SLI, but now you're talking about a real investment, and that is another animal altogether. And of course, let's not forget the fact that we jump from DDR5 to DDR6, which is in itself a great step forward and an amazing and very needed evolution. But when the GeForce GTX 1080 was released 29 months ago, it was retailed at about $150 to $200 cheaper. So that premium we're paying, I'm not sure it's worth it. For, again, for add-ons and additions that we're not going to be able to see for some time. The card has been released, 3 weeks ago, 2 weeks ago? Until now, I do not have a single RT game or a deep learning super sampling game. I don't. And I don't know when I'm gonna get some. So maybe I'll have to do a follow-up video, and that's great, but I cannot tell you with an educated opinion what that's gonna look like. So that's one problem. The second problem for the RTX 2080 is that you do have a card that we benchmarked, who gave absolutely similar gaming performances, classical gaming performances, the 1080 Ti, and better mining performances, and not by a little margin. We had 30-40% better mining performances on Ethereum and ERC20 algorithms, and very similar Zcash. So, you know, it's a better miner for $200 cheaper. The 1080 Ti right now is dropping in prices and available starting, I think I found $620 on Newegg. And you know, that's what, $200 cheaper. So for my money, even though I can see potential, as far as I'm concerned right now, I would wait before buying a 20 series video card. And I'll definitely, and if I was burned to the point of death, I need a new video card, and I had a 1080 or lower, I go for a 1080 Ti. $20 cheaper, similar gaming performances, and better mining if you're a crypto miner. So yeah, win. Again, I'll probably change my mind on a follow-up video in a few weeks or in a month or two, but I doubt it. So yeah, that's it for me.